Dear students, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to deal with the poem No Men Are Foreign by James Kirkup. James Kirkup was an English poet. Okay. So the title No Men Are Foreign means that no men, that means man belongs to another country, are foreign. The poet wants to say that all men are same, all men are equal. He wants to promote the concept of universal brotherhood. That means in this poem, the poet wants us to tell that everyone in this world is same. All people, all men are same. Even though they live in different countries, they speak different languages, they are also human beings, they are same. Okay, they eat, live, die the same way, all of us. Okay, all of us eat, live, die in a same way. Everyone gets the rewards of nature like sunshine, air, land, etc. in equal measure. We all get the things from nature in same quality or amount. So we can say that it is a peace poem. Here in this poem, the poet wants us to tell that all the men in this world are equal, they are same. Okay, all are human beings. Even though they belong to different countries and they differ from language or nationality, all men are same. Okay, we should not consider a man from another country as foreign. All are same. Okay, so let's go to the poem. Remember, no men are strange, no country is foreign. Beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes. Like ours, the land our brothers walk upon is earth like this in which we all shall lie. Okay, so in the first line, the poet says that no men are strange and no country is foreign. Okay, so here he is attempting to remove the borders of each country from the earth, and that borders are erected by people, human beings. So he wanted to remove that borders of different countries. Then only no countries will be foreign. Then only we will feel every country as our own land when there is no borders. Okay, everyone will be free to move around. The poet says that the entire earth is one and all the people who live on this earth belong to one human race. Okay, beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes means here beneath means under, in all uniforms means the different uniforms are worn by soldiers of different country. Each country have their own code of uniform for soldiers. Okay, so here uniforms means the uniforms of soldiers in different countries. Okay, even though their uniforms are different, inside the uniform, the human being is the same. A single body breathes. The body is same. Like ours. It is like ours. Okay. Only the uniform difference, but the body or the human being inside that uniform is same. God has made all of us in a similar way. Okay. All breathe in the same way. Then he says that all the soldiers are our brothers. Okay, all the soldiers are our brothers. We all walk upon the same Mother Earth, and upon our death, we shall lie in the same earth. So, the poet here in the first stanza try to say that no men are strange and no countries are foreign. Okay, beneath all the different uniforms of soldiers, there is a single body breathes. The body of human beings are same. They breathe like all like others. Okay, it is also they are like our brothers. They also walk upon the same earth as we do. And when we all die, we all are buried in the same earth. They too aware of sun and air and water are fed by peaceful harvest, by war's long winter starved. Their hands are ours, and in their lines we read a labor not different from our own. So in the second stanza, the poet says that they means they refers to those people who belong to other country. They too aware of sun and air and water. That means they also get the sun, the gift of nature, as sunlight, air and water in the same quantity as we get. Okay, so we call them foreigners. The people belongs to another country, but nature has given all its things to all people in a same measurement. Everyone gets sunlight, air, water in equal measure, which means that God does not differentiate between people from different countries. To God, all are same. Are fed by peaceful harvest and war's long winter starved. That means the nature provides everything to the people at a in a equal measure, and we all do farming during the time of peace. Peaceful harvest means we all, if there is no war and all, if it is a peaceful time, we all harvest. Harvest means cultivate. Okay, farm. We are farming during the time of peace, when there is no war. Okay, so at that time we live a relaxed life and eat the things given to us by nature. Okay, everyone will be like that if there is no war and all. Okay, but when there is war, we are starving, as we starve during winter time. Okay, in winter time, we cannot cultivate anything and we cannot farm anything. So, there will be starvation. Okay, we will not get enough food and all. So, war is compared like a winter season. Okay, during war also, we won't get sufficient food. Okay, we won't get sufficient food and comforts. Okay. Winter season is very difficult to live, very cold, and starvation will be there. Same like when there is a war, lot of problems will be there. We won't get food and etc. So all these are same for all the people in different countries. Okay, if there is no war, everyone will be happy and comfortable. If there is war, it is like a winter season. We won't get enough food and comforts. Okay. Their hands are ours, and in their lines we read a labor not different from our own. Okay. Even their hands are same as ours. They work very hard just like we do. So all people, their hands are same and all are hardworking in the same way. The poet gives these examples to say that there is no difference in us and the people belonging to another country. There is no difference between we and foreigners. All are same. Remember, They have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be won by love. In every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. The poet asks the reader to remember something. Okay, he says that we should keep in our mind that the people of another country, whom we think as our enemies or foreigners, have been created by God with similar appearance like us. Okay, the people who we think as our enemies also created by God, and they have same appearance or same shape or figure as we have. Okay, God has given them eyes like ours, which open when awake and close when we are asleep. Everyone is like that. All human beings are like that. We open our eyes when we are awake and we close our eyes when we sleep. Okay. Similarly, he has given them strength which we can win through love. Okay. All the human beings are addicted to love. With love, we can achieve anything. Then he says that in every country, in every land, there is one common thing, that is life. Okay. All people who can recognize and understand their feelings, each other, because in common, our life is common in all the countries. The life of human being is same, okay, with same feelings. So everyone can understand and recognize it. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray, contemn. Remember, we who take arms against each other. Okay, so in the fourth stanza, the poet says that we should remember that whenever someone tells us to hate a person from another country or to think him as our own enemy, then we deprive ourselves, we cheat ourselves, and we contemn ourselves. Okay, so who says another country as our enemy? It is the political leaders. Okay, the leaders of that country. Okay, the leaders of the country may tell that that country is our enemy, so we want to fight against it. Okay, so the poet says that whenever someone tells you hate a person from another country, we are not exactly hating that person. We hate ourselves. Okay, we cheat ourselves. Okay, it is very shameful for us. Okay, he says that we should stay away from such negativity. We should not obey the orders of these kind of leaders. Okay, to hate another country, or if they proclaim a war with another country, they have their own benefits to gain. Okay, it is for their purpose, their hidden purpose, they are asking us to fight with other countries. So keep away such negativity. We should not consider anyone to be our enemy. He says that whenever we pick any weapon against someone, we should remember one thing. So whenever we are trying to fight with others, whenever we are trying to use any weapon to other country, against other countries or against other soldiers, we should remember one thing. Okay, what is that? It is the human earth that we defile. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. So what does the poet ask us to remember? When we take weapons against each other, we should remember one thing. Okay, what is that? If we take any weapon against any person, we make the earth dirty. We pollute. We pollute the earth. We make the earth dirty because how it pollutes earth, because when we take weapons or when there is a war, it will kill a lot of person. Okay, and their bodies which fall on the earth make it dirty. There will be lot of dead bodies. Okay, whenever war happens, it leads to a lot of bloodshed, fire and death. Okay, these dead bodies accumulate on the earth and it make it impure. So such a way the earth get polluted. Then another one, the fire of war which erupts, or the fire that comes from guns, short bombs and all. Okay, the fire and the smoke which comes out, the dust. Okay, the smoke, the dust and the fire that comes out from different weapons and buildings will be collapsed. Okay, so the dust, okay, comes from these kinds of activities that fills the air and it is so dirty. Okay, the air become polluted because of smoke and dust from the different weapons used in war. Okay, so the air also get polluted. It destroys the purity of air that is everywhere around. Air is our own. Okay, we get air from nature, so it is our own thing, but when we take weapon, we pollute it. Okay, so the poet wants to give us a message that we should not indulge in war, we should not participate in war. Okay, finally he ends the poem writing the first line in reverse and saying that, remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. Okay, so here in this poem, the poet asks us to consider all human beings as our brothers. Okay, he insists on universal brotherhood. Okay, he says there should not be wars. Okay, if there is a war, everyone suffers. Okay, all the countries, in all people in different countries, the sufferings will be the same and it pollute the earth also. Okay, so we can say that this is a peace poem, or the poet wants to show the need of the importance of universal brotherhood. Hope you understood this. Thank you.